lots and lots of travelling supporters for Pedrero and Grana of Spain. And next up, we have the final of the women's C1 500 metres. A lot of really, really exciting, accomplished paddlers out there in the C1 500. Women's canoe racing, Lani, going from strength to strength. Let's have a look at the lineup out there in this C1 500 metre final. Giada Bragato of Hungary in lane one. Alongside her from Poland in lane two, Magda Stani. Then the reigning world champion from Russia, Ksenia Kurach. She's in lane three. The reigning under 23 world champion and the senior European champion as well, Elena Nazdrova from Belarus. China's Ma Yanan is in lane five, the 2017 junior world champion. So plenty of silverware between these paddlers. Ukraine's Anastasia Chetverikova, the reigning under 23 European champion as well. From Romania, Stefanica Ursu in lane seven. 17-year-old Gulbahar Fayzavia from Uzbekistan in lane eight. And in lane nine from Croatia, Vanessa Tott. Lani, we're just talking about the rise of women's canoe racing now that women's canoe will be in the Olympic Games in Tokyo 2020. Not the C1 500, but the quality of women's canoe boat racing where they're kneeling up as opposed to sitting down is just huge now, isn't it?
Yeah, exactly. I remember when it first came to the World Cups and World Championships, and you know the heats weren't even full, and now to see how much it's grown is really impressive, and it's great for women's sport.
Yeah, three full heats we had in this event, in a non-Olympic event. So really, really brilliant for the profile of the sport, the depth and the quality. And we're underway in this final of the women's C1 500 metres. We've got the reigning world champion out in lane three. That's Ksenia Kurach of Russia, paddling that blue boat out there, reaching out long. But it's Chetverikova of Ukraine in lane six at the moment, who is going nose to nose with Kurach of Russia. And Nazdrova of Belarus is there in contention as well for these medals. Now remember, this is the 500 metres. They've got a little bit further to go. And Lani, there's a little bit more perhaps mental strength involved and a little bit more of a race plan involved than the 200 metres we've just seen.
Yeah, definitely. You can see that they're really stretching out and trying to get as much distance per stroke and apply as much power, but also last over the 500 metres. So it's a little bit more tactical than the 200 all-out dash.
Brilliant, brilliant conditions out there for fast racing. Really friendly conditions, nice and easy on the paddlers, not too bumpy out there, but we still have that world champion, under 23 world champion and under 23 European champion all going nose to nose as they come in to the last 200 metres of this women's C1 500 metre final.
Yeah, it's pretty neck and neck at the moment.
Can Kurach defend her world title from 2018? She has a slight lead over Nazdrova of Belarus at the moment. They're both putting the power down, but it's all going to go down to who has a little bit left in the tank, who's got the power over the last 100 metres.
And who can mentally hold on as well, like who can take the pain the most.
Chetverikova is still in contention, but now Nazdrova of Belarus has powered herself forward. She's just got inches ahead of Kurach of Russia. Will Kurach of Russia lose her world title today? She is slipping back. Nazdrova pushing forward, stretching that lead, and I think it will be Nazdrova of Belarus who takes the gold ahead of Kurach of Russia, who picks up silver, and it's Ukraine's Anastasia Chetverikova who takes the world bronze medal. Brilliant battle between those three.
It's
up the
very
front,
impressive, very impressive. You can see the stroke rate coming up at the end, and not only that, but they've got to steer the boat as well. Like, it's tough, but at least the wind is behind them today and there's no crosswind, so it's pretty fair conditions for them.
And how tough is it when you're, you know, one and two, nose to nose, out the front with someone who's right next to you? How mentally tough is that?
Yeah, it is tough, and you just got to focus on yourself, and if you're going to use the fact that they're there, like, use it positively, and And yeah, focus on what you can do though, and try and get to the finish line as fast as possible.
And you can see here, Najdrava's fantastic finish in that pink boat. She just held on into contention with Kurach over the first 400 meters. But boy, did she put down some power over the last 100. Fantastic endurance, fantastic focus. Just able to focus on herself. And half a boat length, the winning margin in the end for Elena Najdrava of Belarus. She's the reigning under 23 world champion and senior European champion, and now the newly crowned world champion in the women's C1 500 meters.
Yeah, she looks pretty happy with that.
Good number of Belarusian fans out there in the crowd to cheer Najdrava on in that C1 500 meter final. And the winning time, according to this, is